In the following tutorial, we would like to give you a general overview of the most used separation mode for HPLC, namely reversed phase chromatography, and a consideration of the corresponding best-selling Shodex columns, the ASA HiPak, ODP, and ODP2 series. The main applications in this mode are the separation of small organic molecules, which have to be analyzed in different fields, like pharmaceutical industry, environmental analysis, food safety, and life science. If you need further detailed information about the reversed phase mode, as well as about applications with our columns, please take a look at our technical notebook number 6 after this tutorial. In contrast to normal phase chromatography, reversed phase chromatography is performed by using a polar aqueous mobile phase, i.e. mixtures of pure water or buffers and polar organic solvents, for example, acetonitrile, methanol, etc., and a nonpolar stationary phase. This combination of chromatographic conditions leads to a separation of small organic compounds like drugs by their polarity. Hence, the following illusion order is obtained by reversed phase chromatography. Highly polar compounds are not well retained by the nonpolar base material due to their very weak physical interactions towards the surface of the packing material and therefore elute fast. Weakly polar compounds, which are consisting of polar as well as nonpolar moieties, interact stronger with the stationary phase than polar compounds and consequently elute later. The strongest interactions are appearing between nonpolar compounds and the nonpolar stationary phase, which leads to the best retention. Therefore, these nonpolar analytes will elute later than more polar ones. Shodex's focus lies on manufacturing HPLC columns which consist of pure polymer-based stationary phases instead of silica-based ones. The most important reason is that polymer-based particles are chemically more resistant and offer therefore a broader application range. In the case of reversed phase columns, there are several improved methods to modify silica particles with alkyl chains, for example C18, among others the use of monomeric or polymeric alkyl silanes. Nevertheless, not all free silanol groups can be occupied by these methods, even not after end-capping procedures. Therefore, still high silanol contents are present, which leads to several drawbacks. Traditional silica-based reversed phase columns are unstable under basic conditions, i.e. pH above 7, and adsorb basic as well as highly polar compounds. The ASA HiPak ODP series is one of the most important reversed phase columns in Shodex assortment. As the stationary phase consists of pure polymer-based C18 particles, the limitations and drawbacks of traditional silica-based reversed phase columns are overcame. For this column type, C18 modified polyvinyl alcohol particles are used as stationary phase. In general, polymer-based columns, especially the ODP series, can be used within an extended pH range from 2 to 13, whereas silica-based ones only up to 7.5. In addition, 100% water can be used as eluent to avoid contamination of some sensitive compounds by organic solvents. Due to the missing free silanol groups, a simple analysis of basic substances is possible. That means there is no need for high salt concentrations or iron pair reagents to obtain high resolutions as well as nice peak shapes. The polymeric material shows also higher chemical robustness and can therefore offer a 2 to 3 times higher lifetime when compared to silica-based columns. We offer this type of reversed phase column in different column dimensions, ranging from semi-prep analytical to semi-micro scale. The latter is commonly used for LC-MS applications. Furthermore, it has to be considered that the stationary phase has a quite big pore size of 250 angstrom, which makes it also suitable for the separation and analysis of peptides and small proteins up to circa 20,000 Dalton. You can find more detailed information in our catalogue or on our website. To give you an idea about the separation efficiency and the area of applications, two examples on this slide are given. On the left side, you can see the analysis of a complex sample containing fat-soluble vitamins, for example, vitamin A, D, E and K. Thereby, you can see that even if the molecule structures differ slightly, like in the case of vitamin D2 and D3, a separation could be achieved with our ODP column under isocratic conditions. One of the most important advantages of the OTP series is the possibility to analyze basic substances like local anesthetics in a simple way without adding any additives. In this case, when you compare the different pH ranges, only a baseline separation can be achieved under harsh basic conditions, i.e. pH 11, which would not be possible in the case of silica-based reversed phase columns. Thereby, the pH is higher than the pKa of the analytes, which results in a better interaction between analytes and a stationary phase, and consequently to a better retention of the former. Based on the big pore sizes of 250 angstrom, also an effective separation of peptides and small proteins up to 20,000 Dalton by applying a linear gradient is possible. Furthermore, the analysis of proteins shows a good reproducibility, which is related to their almost similar elution volumes and high recovery rates, in most cases over 90%. This clearly demonstrates that almost no adsorption of peptides and proteins is taking place, whereas in the case of silica-based columns, high adsorption is occurring. Beside the C18 modified ODP series, Shodex offers further columns for reversed phase chromatography. One of them is the polymer-based ODP2 series, whose base material consists of unmodified polyhydroxymethacrylate particles. This stationary phase is slightly more polar compared to the ODP series, and therefore shows a better retention of more polar compounds. As in this case again, a pure polymer-based stationary phase is used, this column can be used in an extended pH range from 2 to 12. Therefore, the simple analysis of basic compounds without the use of any additives is still possible. This material also shows lower bleeding when compared to silica-based columns, and is therefore suitable for particle-sensitive detection methods like MS. The ODP2 series can also be offered in different column dimensions for semi-preparative / analytical, as well as for semi-micro purposes. With a small pore size of 40 angstrom, these columns are suitable for biological samples without time-consuming sample pretreatments to remove protein matrices. Further information and applications can be found in our catalogue and on our website. As mentioned before, our polymer-based columns show a significant higher stability compared to silica-based ODS columns under alkaline conditions. On this slide, you can see a direct comparison between our ODP2 column and a silica-based ODS column. In both cases, we've applied the same alkaline stability tests. Thereby, a sample containing pyridine and phenol was injected in two new columns, ODP2, HP-4D and ODS. In both cases, a baseline separation of the analytes could be achieved. After the first sample injection, both columns were flushed with sodium phosphate buffer, acetonitrile mixture with a high pH of 12. In the case of our ODP2 column, even after 500 hours of alkaline treatment, the chromatogram was reproducible, showing the robustness of this material against harsh basic conditions. In contrast to that, the ODS column showed an irreversible deterioration after 24 hours extensive alkaline treatment, resulting in peak overlapping and deformation in both cases. Therefore, no further baseline separation can be achieved, which makes it impossible to determine both compounds quantitatively. In this case, the column has to be replaced for further measurements. Moreover, the ODP2 series has small pore sizes of 40 angstrom, which makes it suitable for protein removal. Therefore, samples with protein matrices, for example blood serum, can be directly injected without time-consuming sample pretreatment. As a proof of suitability, a sample containing BSA, a small protein of 60,000 Dalton, was injected in two new columns, ODP2HB-2B and ODSA. Thereby, in the case of ODS-A, a multilayer adsorption of the protein was observed over 140 consecutive injections, resulting in a significantly higher column back pressure. Therefore, the column has to be exchanged for further injections and analyses. In the case of our column ODP2HP-2B, the back pressure was quite stable over 140 injections, showing that no adsorption is taking place on the polymeric material. The ODP2 series is suitable for the analysis of drugs in biological samples, i.e., samples with protein matrices, without extensive sample pretreatment in combination with MS detection. To avoid interference between the protein and the MS detector, the valve has to be switched after the protein has passed the column to introduce the drug. In this example, barbitol for MS detection. When a sample with a complex matrix is analyzed, the effect of co-adsorption has to be considered. That means when the matrix is adsorbed on the column, a co-adsorption of the target drug usually is also obtained. Therefore, no exact quantitative determinations can be applied. For this reason, some tests with our ODP2 series were made. On the left side, you can see a blank sample injection without BSA, resulting in 100% recovery of barbitol as expected. On the right side, the real sample with BSA was injected. In this case, also almost 100% of barbitol could be recovered as well, because no adsorption of BSA and therefore also no co-adsorption on our polymeric material is taking place. When this co-adsorption experiment is also applied to a silica-based ODS-A column, adsorption of BSA as well as co-adsorption of barbitol is taking place, resulting in a significant lower recovery rate of barbitol. Therefore, the requirements for a quantitative determination in the case of silica-based ODS columns are not given, as this co-adsorption phenomenon cannot be controlled. When basic substances are analyzed with silica-based columns, free selenyl groups and neutral conditions can have negative influences on the separation, as well as causing peak broadening. Therefore, to achieve a good separation of basic compounds on silica-based columns, ion pair reagents have to be added to the eluent to avoid unwanted interactions. When polymeric stationary phases are used, the same analysis can be performed under alkaline conditions at pH 11 and without ion pair reagents to obtain nice peak shapes. Therefore, you can avoid the contamination of your column with ion pair reagents, which usually make them unusable for other applications. For LC-MS applications, salt concentrations of the eluent buffer should be held as low as possible to avoid interferences in the detection. To visualize the influence of salt concentrations on the peak shape as well as intensity, several measurements were applied. In all cases, ammonium acetate buffer at pH 7 was used. On the right side, you can see the experiments considering ODS-A and ODS-B columns. In both cases, when the salt concentration is reduced from 10 mm to 1 mm, a strong deformation of the peak shapes resulting in fronting and tailing, and a decrease in intensity are obtained. In comparison to that, you can see on the left side that a decrease of salt concentration in the case of our ODP2 column has no influence on the peak appearance. If you need further info material, please register on our website www.shodex.de. There you can find PDF files for download, i.e. our column and detector catalogues, technical notebooks, and you have access to our application data bank. In the case you need support, please contact us via info@shodex.de. For quotes or purchase orders, please send us an email via order@shodex.de. Moreover, we offer further tutorials considering HILIC, ligand exchange, ion, and size exclusion chromatography. Thank you very much for your kind attention.